In this video, I'm going to go over the process of swapping a hard drive out on a MacBook Pro. This is a mid-2012 MacBook Pro. This probably applies to some other models. In a previous video, I cloned the drive inside to an external USB drive using Time Machine and the recovery console, and I'll link to that in the description. So I've got here a Samsung 1 terabyte SSD, and I'll put links in the description for the equipment I'm using here. This is a Sabrent USB drive enclosure, and those will be Amazon affiliate links, and if you use those, that helps out my channel a little bit. So first off, I'm going to remove all the perimeter screws. I have a 4-0 screwdriver here. I like to work on a clean flat surface and then take the screws out and just place them adjacent to where I take them out of the computer so I don't lose them. Some people will use tape or something to hold them so they don't lose them. Now I like to use quite a bit of downward pressure while I'm taking these screws out. Now when you put these back in, they do have a little bit of Loctite on them, and you could replace the Loctite. I tend to not do that. You know, if you were doing this for a client or something, you may want to do that so the screws don't come loose. I just feel around, and if I feel a screw come loose, I'll just tighten it back down. I have all the screws out now, so I can just lift the back off. It comes off pretty easy. And now we've accessed the inside of the computer. Okay, so now we can see the hard drive inside of this. It looks very similar because I'm replacing a 500 gigabyte drive with a terabyte drive. So to get it out, we'll loosen these screws with the hard drive bracket. And actually, we only have to loosen the brackets on the one side. So it's the two screws. And then we can unplug this. You want to be very careful here. Pull this out evenly. And now we have the hard drive out. We'll need to get a screwdriver and change these screws and move them into the new hard drive. Okay, so these screws here are a T6 Torx here. I'll put a link in the description to one of these. And I'll just take them out of the old drive and put them into the new drive. Okay, so I've inserted all these screws off camera here, and then we'll just plug the drive in. We'll tilt it back into the bracket here, make sure it's seated properly. We'll put this bracket back on and tighten it down. And now we have the hard drive installed. We can replace the back cover. And one thing I like to do, you have to make sure you don't knock any of your screws off around here, but I like to carefully turn this over and open it up and make sure it boots. And if it doesn't, you can put the old hard drive back in. So I have the Apple symbol. And it boots. So I can actually shut it down. Seeing the startup screen is good enough for me. Okay, it's shut back down. I'll carefully lift this up because the bottom plate is still loose. And I'll just replace all the screws. And I like to put them all in, start them, and then after they're all started, I'll go around and make sure they're all tight. Okay, and that's the finished product here. We have a hard drive swapped out on this Mac. Like I said, I'll put the link in the description to the video where I talk about cloning the drive using Time Machine. And if you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And if this was helpful, please give this video a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye.